Welcome to another episode of the Valorant Tips and Tricks Sent by You series, a series where I show Valorant tips and tricks that you guys send to me. Like always, I'll be giving away one battle pass to one random submission. If you want to submit something, feel free to join my Discord server or tag me on Twitter. Also, at the time of this recording, I'm turning 21, so thank you for all the birthday wishes. And the last thing, if you got a clip where you used one of the tricks during the series, feel free to send it in this channel and the Discord. I want to make a compilation video of all the tricks in use. I'll also give away some battle passes to some submissions. Anyway, let's start the video. Chamber, you can place one side of your teleport in Lamps, then walk all the way to B side and place your other teleporter in Cubby. Now you can go for a very fast rotate towards Lamps if you want to. However, be careful, don't use it from Lamps towards Cubby, because if you do that, you'll teleport in the open and people from B long can see you. Let's stay on bind and go towards Hookah for another cool chamber trick. In Hookah, there are a lot of pots where you can hide your traps in. Enemies might have struggled spotting them, so they don't destroy it that easily. Just don't use the same setup every round and you'll be golden. A very good strat, my friends. If you're stuck in this corner with KO, you can do a nice trick. Just do a right click throw and it will be a one way flashbang towards C long and garage. You could either throw it, wait a while and then peek, this way the enemies will be flashed when you peek. Or be risky, throw it and immediately peek, the enemies won't be flashed yet, but they might look away and you can shoot them while they turn. But still, the last strat is a little bit risky. With Cypher on icebox, if you jump on nest and then on the big box over here, you can place a very good cam. If you look up, you can't place it over there, but if you jump, you can place it a little bit higher and from here you can see the whole site. Just don't use the spot every round, because once the enemy see it, they might pre-shoot it. But still, it's very hard to spot it, so good luck, my friend. Let's go towards mid and talk about the wallbang spot I didn't know about. Sometimes you see people cross towards tube, but you cannot connect your shots. In that case, you can wallbang tube, of course. But did you know that you can also wallbang this white wall over here? Only thing you have to know is that you have to stand on the very left of ramp. And maybe you can get a kill like Smushy Soda.
Well, one was lurking B, I got lucky.
Kitchen. Oh, nice.
Here a quick and easy sofa lineup on Fracture. When you are standing in hell, aim at the right of the iron bar and shoot your arrow with full charge and two bounces. Your arrow will spot enemies standing in CT, very nice. Now a very cool Viper trick on split. When you got control over ramp, go to this corner and aim at the line. The angle of your ultimate only works when you aim exactly at the line. After that, cast your ult of course, and now you can walk to side easy peasy. The enemies won't be able to see you. Of course, from the enemy's perspective, it might be very obvious that you're all walking through your ultimate, so I'd recommend to use this wall and then push with your team towards site, kill the enemy that's defending from site and then plant easy peasy. If someone is standing on rafters for example, they cannot see you. Now let's go to the other side of split for a nice cypher trick. When you plant a spike over here, you can use a nice one-way camera where you can see the feet of the enemy. Go to garage and place your camera on the airco. And that's it, you can spot when the enemy is defusing, because then the spike will turn red. And of course you can also tag the enemies if you want to. The reason that the enemies cannot see your camera is because you only can see their feet. So this is not bug abuse, but it's the way that perspective works in Valorant. Very OP if you ask me. Let's play a game. Can you spot the chamber traps? I give you a second. No, if you look carefully, it's beneath this ramp. It's a good hiding spot, my friends. Enemies won't be able to see it. But it gets even crazier. Here, another chamber hiding spot. You can actually hide your trap under the roster. That's actually pretty cool. I didn't know this was possible. I personally don't think this is a bug, but it's intentional. But I'm not sure, so be careful with using this one. Also, it's pretty hard to spot for the enemies. And yes, it does actually activate when people walk over it. Very, very good.
I have them.
Now a very situational jet trick. On bind, use your ultimate, jump at this spot and do a double updraft. From here you can look towards market. Very good, and this next one is even more situational, but maybe you can use it. You can also jump over here and do a double updraft, then you can look towards the attacking spawn. Hey, you never know, you might be able to use it. Now a very unique chamber mechanic. When you have a sheriff in your hand, you can shoot and then immediately switch to your own gun and shoot again. You can do it very fast and still be accurate. But my guess is that Riot will change this in the future. And by the way, it also kinda works with an operator. Cool trick though. Now a trick you can use with every agent who can go to high places. In the attacking spawn on ascent, there's this hut. Just go on top of it. From here you can look all the way to A main and kill enemies that are pushing. And when the enemies are pushing, they have to flick all the way up and they probably won't expect you there. Nice. If you are playing Sage on split, a very common wall is this one on middle. But sometimes you place it too early and then you hear that the enemies are A. To still be a little bit useful, stand on this strange tile and aim at the corner of the crane. Throw your orb and it will land exactly at A main. This is a nice orb to give you some extra time to rotate. Now a nice combo you can do with some teammates. When your teammates want to go for an aggressive garage peek, you can do a nice trick with Breach. From B Heaven, use your aftershock towards garage. When the enemies are pushed out a little bit, they can't run back. So they have to walk in your teammates' crosshair or in your aftershock. A very nice trick, my friends. Legendary Cookie got some sneaky kills with this one. About sneaky kills, in an earlier video I said that you should never shoot on the zipline unless the enemy see you. You'll be very inaccurate, and especially with an operator. Look at these shots. Like the operator is very inaccurate at the zip line. But still, Deadly Dude somehow got a kill. Wow. Now a pretty good cipher cage on ascent. Cage lineups are often underrated, so if you want to learn one, learn this one. Jump on the fishies, then walk a little bit to the right till you see a crack in the sky. Aim at the top of the crack and then throw your cage. Your cage will land in market and the enemies won't be able to see anything. So activate it, push, and easy peasy for you. With Sova on Breeze, you can use this decoy lineup. Stand against these boxes and aim at the little stone on the ground. It looks hard, but once you know it, it's very easy to remember. Believe me. Shoot the arrow with full charge and 2 bounces and it will fly all the way to mid window. But as you saw, the arrow flies pretty slow and the enemies probably will see it coming. But that's why it's called a decoy arrow. The enemy will go back because they see the arrow and now you have control over mid. You can either wait till the enemy peeks again or push forward and take more control over mid. A nice one if you don't have any smokes in your team or your teammate doesn't want to smoke mid. Yeah. With Viper, if you use your ult on top of heaven, hell will be clear. When you jump down, you see that the ult doesn't reach hell. It creates a little air pocket. That's pretty funny and it can be useful. For example, in the post plant, when you plant a spike on the edge, you can see the spike and you can see when it's being diffused. Also, if you like this video this far, feel free to give it a like. It really helps growing my channel. Thank you so much. The next one is a bug. Don't use it, but it's pretty cool, so I wanted to show it in this video. You can place your camera in between these boxes and then you can look through the boxes. A nice one if you want to catch enemies rotating. I'm not sure who found it out, but it's a cool trick. And here's a trick someone made in Paint. If you want, you can pause the video. Very creative though. With Jet, you can jump on these boxes, then on the big box, updraft, and you can look over the door. Now you can do woonk 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 sneaky peeky kills for you, my friend. We have a lot of chamber tricks in this video, but he's a cool agent, so why not another one? It's not really a trick, but more like a tip. When you place your trap down, always place a teleporter kinda close. For example, over here on split. So when you hear your trap going off, you can immediately teleport and go for that sneaky kill. Just like Jace did. Or JC. Sorry if I pronounce it wrong.
There they are.
Enemy remaining.
Now cool Viper one way. Stand in this corner and aim at the tip of the building. Easy to remember, throw your smoke and it will land on the ledge. This one is useful if you are the defenders and take control over satellite. Your teammate hold behind, you hold A main, easy round for you. Now a brimstone molly that I actually never thought was possible, but there's a small gap you can use. Stand in this corner and aim at the sign while aligning your crosshair with the building on the back. Hard to explain, easy to remember, shoot your molly and it will land on the default plant. If you combine this with your ultimate, you literally cannot lose this round. Very cool. I've also never seen this breach trick. When you plant the spike in this corner on fracture, jump on the boxes and go towards satellite. From here you can use your aftershock through the ramp right onto the spike. Just use your minimap so you know exactly where to aim. A good one for the post plant. Now a boombot lineup you can do at the start of the round. On bind, stand against the barrier on the left side and aim at the top of the jug. Then activate your boombot. It will drive all the way to lamps. I really like this one because it catches people camping on the left. It will even activate if the enemies are standing on top of the boxes. Very nice. Now two unique sofa lineups that are basically the same. On ascent, stand in this corner and aim a little bit above the top of the flag. After that, either shoot your arrow with full charge and 1 bounce or full charge and 2 bounces. The arrow you activate with 1 bounce will land behind the generator and the second arrow will bounce again and go towards heaven. So a nice one if you forget your lineups. You can do 2 lineups with only 1 lineup. Very good. And this is the end of the video. Thank everyone so much for submitting their tricks. And don't forget, if you made some kills using some of these tricks, feel free to send it in my Discord. Thank you so much for watching. Bye bye.